External ballistics study the behavior of the projectile in flight. The deceleration due to drag depends on the density of air, which is lower at high temperatures and altitudes and higher humidity. The rest of the factors depend on the projectile and how it was released. The mass is inversely proportional to the deceleration, and if nothing else changes, more mass is better. The cross-section area is proportional to the deceleration. 10% increase of diameter means 21% increase of area and deceleration. Longer projectiles will have more mass for the same cross-section, which can reduce deceleration. Cross-section also changes with angle of attack. The velocity depends on the internal ballistics, and more is better, even though deceleration is proportional to the square of the velocity. The drag coefficient is just a number and changes with shape, velocity, and surface roughness. Drag coefficient and shape. Using a more streamlined shape reduces drag significantly. Drag coefficient and velocity. The drag coefficient changes through the flight as velocity changes. The Reynolds number increases with speed and length of the projectile. A decrease in the drag coefficient does not necessarily decrease drag. The drag force is proportional to the square of the velocity, which offsets the decrease in the drag coefficient. But there is a significant drop in the drag coefficient, which is called drag crisis. This large reduction in drag coefficient is due to the flow of the boundary layer becoming turbulent, which moves the separation point further on the rear of the body, reducing the size of the wake and the magnitude of the pressure drag. Drag coefficient and relative roughness. Projectiles have a sweet speed bracket in which they experience lower drag. This speed bracket can be moved to lower or higher speeds by changing the roughness of the surface of the projectile. This is why golf balls are dimpled. Roughness is the most difficult thing to understand and quantify. Let's take a look at this research article. Glass beads of different sizes were pasted on the surface of the sphere to give a variation in the value of roughness. The finest roughness was obtained by abrading the surface with sandpaper to obtain grooves of approximately 50 micrometers depth. It can be seen that the slightly roughened surface causes the critical Reynolds to reduce from about 400,000 to 270,000, whereas the minimum drag coefficient remains about the same. Increasing the roughness causes the critical Reynolds to reduce dramatically from about 80,000, with a significant increase in the minimum drag coefficient. It can be seen that only a small amount of roughness, equivalent to applying sandpaper, is needed to reduce the critical Reynolds number appreciably, and that the relationship is roughly exponential. An increasing size of roughness has less and less effect. Including whistle holes or inscriptions on the projectile design will have an effect on drag. Although there is no specific research on the matter, the ancients probably used lead projectiles with inscriptions or holes because they were getting better ranges. Spherical or blunt shapes can have too little optimal roughness. In contrast, the same roughness can have the opposite effect in streamlined bodies. Streamlining has opposite effects on pressure and friction drag. It decreases pressure drag by delaying boundary layer separation and decreasing the pressure difference between the front and back of the body, and increases the friction drag by increasing the surface area aligned with the direction of the flow. Also, friction drag increases with roughness. For blunt bodies with sharp corners, such as this rectangular block, separation occurs at the edges of the front and back surfaces. The drag coefficient of a long rectangular rod can be reduced almost by half, from 2.2 to 1.2, by rounding the corners. Marble, long. Too much drag. Marble, less ankles. The rounded rectangular projectile had a graceful flight and a visible impact at 170 meters and was easy to recover. To get an idea of the effects of density, shape and roughness on drag, I will run simulations on the Sling Sim map. This is the only simulator I know of that includes roughness input and graphs the velocity and drag. First, we can see the difference in range of projectiles while changing the length and keeping the diameter the same. This changes the mass and ratio at the same time. Then we can see the difference in range of different ratios while keeping mass the same. What changes is ratio, length and diameter, and mass remains the same. We can also see the effect of different roughnesses. The results of this app and any app are qualitative, and this can be seen in Iron Goober's throw, which reached longer range in real life. The reason is that apps don't take into account lift and angle of attack changes through the flight. Lift deserves a video of its own. The effect of the spin rate on drag is expected to be negligible, although it is possible that it creates turbulence at even lower speeds. Here you can see different projectiles with increasing roughness. Sling projectiles usually have a length to width ratio lower than 3:1. Most of the drag will be pressure drag, so some roughness is desired. If there are already deformities on the shape, smaller scale roughness may be undesirable. The correct balance can only be found through experimentation. The concrete is a marble dust mix with density 2 grams per milliliter or less. It is 6.7 by 2.7 centimeters and has similar mass, higher roughness and reaches lower range than Iron Goober's projectile for similar speeds. Changes for optimization could be a more pointy shape, a denser concrete mix, light sanding to remove the extreme roughness and maybe paint to make it even smoother. Projectiles made of lead will be smaller for the same mass. This will lower the Reynolds number for the same initial speed. So engravings, whistle holes or ridges may lower the critical Reynolds enough to reduce drag for a big part of the flight. This theory needs experimental confirmation. Reversely, stone of the same ratio will be bigger and have a higher Reynolds number, so it will need less roughness to reach the drag crisis.